next on the Met Report, a complete renovation and a partnership with Comcast has an old campus theater made new.
One local mall starts charging for parking, leaving customers and business owners alike upset.
We used to shop here like every weekend and we're not doing it anymore.
The new smoking regulations on campus have been in place for over a year. Coming up, I'll have an update on how students feel about the policies.
It's a good starting point for our university because it shows our students what our stance on this and how we feel about smoking on our campus.
The men's team went up to Golden to compete in the second round of the RMAC tournament. The Met Report starts now.
Thanks for joining us on the Met Report. I'm Patrick Ortiz-Johnson.
Good afternoon, I'm Jhocelyn Avendaño. A lawsuit filed in U.S. District Court against the university accuses the school of creating a hostile work environment and retaliation. The suit was filed in court on Wednesday on behalf of two former professors, Kristen Watson and Cameron Sahami. Sahami even served as the president of the MSU Denver's faculty president for three terms. They claim they were terminated or reprimanded after reporting incidents of sexual misconduct on another professor. We are choosing not to name that professor who is still employed by the university as they are not directly named in the lawsuit. We have also been unable to confirm the allegations to be true. The university released a statement saying, quote, MSU Denver denies the allegations contained in this complaint, end quote. Whenever the university is sued, the case is referred to the legislation unit of the attorney's general office. We have reached out to Watson's and Sahami's attorney's office and district courts to get a copy of the lawsuit documents. We will have more on this next week. And there have been many changes to the area campus, one of them being our smoking policy. Our reporter Miranda McCoshkins has the update.
It's been 1 year since I introduced you all to the new smoking policy on our area, so I decided to see whether or not it's being followed and if there are any more changes.
Since the smoking policies were updated last year, smoking continues to be an ongoing discussion around Auraria.
I like the smoking zones.
Honestly, I feel like it's discrimination.
One of the biggest changes was the addition of the 9 smoking zones.
It's a good starting point for our university because it shows our students what our stance on this and how we feel about smoking on our campus in general.
According to a survey conducted by SACAB in 2014, 73% of students were in favor of designated smoking locations, and only 27% were against it.
Some students are happy with the results of the smoking zones.
I think it makes the campus like cleaner and nicer.
I don't smell cigarette smoke that often.
Some smokers like Tony Swagger respect the smoking policy.
Try to follow the rules and stay within the designated zone so people who don't want to smell my smoke don't have to.
Yet you can still find the little smoking buds littered around campus.
Even though there are signs like these scattered all around campus to let students know where exactly these smoking zones are.
Something that we're struggling with too still is making sure that our students do know that we do have smoking zones and where they are.
Some just refuse.
I'm gonna smoke anywhere regardless.
At some point it seems like we're all just being corralled into one spot.
And within the smoking and tobacco policy, that includes chewing tobacco and vaping, which is another hot topic.
There are many different student opinions. However, for now, the smoking policy remains.
It is also very difficult as an ex-smoker to be around smokers because all I want to do is bum a cigarette.
SACAB Tobacco Force Chair Dominic Lucera told me that originally UCD was for the smoking zones, but against a smoke-free campus, while MSU Denver and CU Denver were supportive of the idea of smoke-free Auraria. As SACAB representatives discussed policies this year, Lucero said that UCD may possibly be open to a smoke-free campus in the future.
Thanks, Miranda.
As college tuition continues to rise, some students are resorting to GoFundMe to finance their education. Over 130,000 GoFundMe accounts have raised approximately $60 million from over 850,000 donors in the last 3 years. As the trend for crowdsourcing and educational funds grew, GoFundMe created the College Hub as a resource for students and their parents. The hub provides a guidebook that gives step-by-step instructions on how to launch a successful GoFundMe campaign and state specific data on the funds raised.
Auraria Campus Parking Services offers 2 shuttle services for commuters. The Night Rider Shuttle provides rides to and from Auraria campus buildings and parking lots after dusk. The Campus Accessible Shuttle Service is a transportation program for those with disabilities who need rides within the boundaries of campus and CU's building across Spear Boulevard. Details can be found on the Parking Transportation website.
All right, thanks for joining us, guys. We're gonna take a look at our beautiful Denver skyline along with the Auraria campus. As you guys can see, it's definitely a little sunny outside with some partly scattered clouds. A beautiful day to go ahead and go outside and walk and get some fresh air since the weather looks so great outside. You can see a bunch of students are walking around on the campus. And then we're gonna take a look at our current temperature. So we're at a great 68 degrees outside. The relative humidity is at 17%. And our winds are coming from the southwest portion, coming 5 to 10 miles per hour. Definitely sunny outside, but we're seeing a little scattered clouds. Looking at our Denver Almanac, our average for today has been 53 degrees with a low of 25. And our record back in 1989 was 79 degrees, and our lowest seen in 1932 at -3. We're gonna go ahead and take a look at our day planner here on Friday. 3 p.m. it's gonna be 69 degrees, partly cloudy. Looking at 6 o'clock, 63 degrees again with the clouds. And at 9 p.m., if you have any evening activities, I would definitely bring a jacket because it's going to be a 54 degrees. If you have any pictures to share with us, go ahead and Facebook or tweet them or Instagram them to us at all at the Met Report.
Students in the STEM field have an early start to a bright future. Denver School of Science and Technology is partnering with the University of Colorado Denver to give juniors a head start. UCD will give free early admission to DSST public school juniors who are at a cumulative 3.0 GPA or higher. Students who are accepted through the partnership are still required to complete SAT or ASCT testing and graduation requirements. DSST public schools have 8 campuses and plan to have 11 by 2025. First-year students accepted into the program will begin college in the fall of 2018. On March 15th, MSU Denver will be having a faculty recital held in the King Center's Concert Hall. The recital will be performed by 3 faculty members of Metro's music program. Tickets are starting at $8, but are free with a Metro ID. Be sure to give your tickets early if you are interested, because they can sell quick.
Well, Patrick, a historical landmark on campus has undergone a major renovation.
Alina Perry is with us now and has more on the efforts.
That's right, Patrick and Jocelyn. I went down to where the Stars Film Center once stood and took a look at the new Comcast Center to see what this new renovation has in store for the campus.
In the heart of the Tivoli holds the remaining pieces of what used to be the Stars Film Center. What was once an area for shows and movie events is now closed doors to the public and padlocked away. The ticket counter is now nothing but an empty frame and space. And the rest of the theater is slowly being transformed and covered up by what is in store for the future.
So unfortunately, the Stars Film Center will not be making a comeback here at the Tivoli anytime soon. But renovations were just completed one floor below for a new center that focuses primarily on the media and technology.
Just a quick trip down the stairs and you will discover a much more lively and updated area. I sat down with the co-director of the Comcast Center to see what all went into the $5 million renovation.
It's a research and innovation entrepreneurial space that's going to be used for exactly that, for working on research projects and involving students working on research projects, both from internal grants as well as external grants, and doing research and development for external corporations.
The Comcast Center said they encourage anyone with a research idea in the units of design, computer science, or other various research work to get involved. For the Met Report.
Thanks, Alina. If you're looking for something to do this Friday night, make sure you check the Auraria Campus West African Dance Class this evening from 6 to 7 p.m. The class will take place in the King Center Music and Dance Studio. Free parking will be available in the 7th Street parking garage. For more information on the event, you can visit msudenver.edu/music.
When we come back, how Denver is gearing up for St. Patrick's Day.
We spoke with one of MSU Denver's up-and-coming performers.
not the same as it was.
Logan, it's time.
Last ride, an old man.
This is what life looks like. Feel it. Are you ready?
Logan, rated R, now playing.
Whether it's local news or world news, the Met Report delivers. Along with politics, sports, entertainment, and weather, our Student Emmy Award-winning newscast features only the best. Tune in live to the Met Report every Friday at 12:30 p.m. on Campus Channel 20, Comcast Channel 58, or mymetmedia.com.
Wildfires broke out near Picayune Strand staff near the forest in Florida last Monday. Although no official statement called for evacuations for the fire that burned throughout the night, voluntary evacuations were underway. The National Weather Service did issue a smoke advisory until 9 a.m. the next morning. Officials described the situation as intense fire behavior spreading 3,500 acres. The cause of the fire is still unknown.
Denver police are asking for the public's help to find this man. They say he was involved in several incidents of unlawful sexual contact on the light rail last week. Anyone with information is asked to call Metro Denver Crime Stoppers at 303-913-STOP. Tipsters can remain anonymous and are eligible for a cash reward. St. Patrick's Day is just around the corner, which means so is the St. Patrick's Day Parade. On Saturday, March 11th, Denver will be holding their 55th annual St. Patrick's Day Parade. The parade route goes from Coors Field on Winecoop, down 17th, and up Blake.
The Cherry Creek Mall recently started charging for parking, a move upsetting not only just customers, but also business owners. Yakaira Hernandez has more straight from the mall.
We're standing outside of the Cherry Creek Mall due to the issues that have been happening with the parking changes. A lot of the business managers inside of the Cherry Creek Mall have been having trouble with their customers, the usual customers who used to come all the time. They don't want to come anymore, since they don't want to pay a fee to be able to park inside of the mall.
Well, we're not very happy about it. We used to shop here like every weekend and we're not doing it anymore.
The Cherry Creek Mall has been losing a lot of customers due to this issue. The Met Report will have a full story with more details within the few weeks. For the Met Report, Yahaira Hernandez.
One of the most used apps today has hit the stock market. The popular app Snapchat has decided to take their incorporation to the next level by selling shares. Snap Inc. started with 3 cents a share, now putting them at a 44% increase with a value of $24 billion. Investors are currently interested in Snap Inc., not for their current state, but for the potential of the app gaining even more popularity.
Well, Patrick, we are officially in the snowiest month of the year, but with how things are going on right now, we wouldn't even know it.
That's right. Emma Dickinson is with us now with the full forecast. Emma, where's the snow at?
That's right, guys. We are in the snowiest month of the year. There is actually a high pressure system that's moving through Colorado right now that's keeping us down here in Denver nice, warm, and dry. But in the northern part of Colorado, in the Front Range, they are experiencing some snow. And if we look to our friends over here in the east, the northeast, and the southeast, they're definitely experiencing some rain down here and some snow up in the northeast. We're going to go ahead and look at our forecast for the evening. Tonight, it's going to be partly cloudy, 41 degrees, again, winds between 5 and 10 miles per hour, so not too windy. And our sunset is going to be at 6 p.m. tonight. We're moving into that daylight savings time, so we're getting a little bit more sun in our evenings. Now we're going to be moving into our forecast for tomorrow. So it is nice and sunny tomorrow. Luckily, a 25% chance of rain, and it is gonna be 56 degrees, so nice and warm. But I would bring a jacket with you just in case we do get that chance of rain, and it might be a little bit windy. Again, winds coming from the northeast, 5 to 10 miles an hour, and our sunrise is gonna be at 6:17 a.m. We're gonna take a look at our 3-day forecast. So Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, again Saturday, like I was saying, 56 degrees, nice and sunny. And then Sunday and Monday, it's going to be slightly cloudy. Sunday, though, we have some nice warm weather at 65 degrees. And again on Monday, 56 degrees. Our lowest temperatures are going to be between the lower 30s and the higher 30s. Now we're going to look at our extended forecast for the week. Again, Sunday, it's going to be nice, and Saturday, it's going to be nice, 56 degrees, and then moving towards Sunday and Monday, a little bit cloudy, and on Friday, we're going to have a nice warm temperature of 74 degrees, nice and warm to start out our spring break. So our week is looking really nice, between the 50s and 70s, so really nice getting into that spring weather, which I know we are all looking forward to for the week.
Oh, hello there. I'm Avery Anderson, host of the Nightly Met here on Channel 58. Do you like watching television that's witty and funny? Maybe you enjoy seeing local performers being highlighted, or you like to watch fun interviews with local citizens. If that's the case, then don't watch our show. We're just college kids, so the jokes are only funny some of the time. The bands suck, and the interviews are awkward to watch. But if that sounds good to you, make sure you tune in every Friday night at 7 p.m. or go to mymetmedia.com.
Oh.
David?
Jake, this is my mother.
I didn't think anybody would be home.
Why were you not at lunch?
Stop acting like a disgruntled pelican.
Oh.
Oh my God. Alexis, this is Jake. We seem to have caught the boys in
an afternoon delight. Is that term still a going thing?
Oh, no. Never say that again.
Don't do that.
A young American soldier, a mysterious French girl, and the love affair that's stolen Broadway's heart. An American in Paris. The spectacular Tony Award-winning musical the New York Times calls a triumph. See why Paris has become the toast of Broadway. An American in Paris.
Plays the Buell Theater March 8th through the 19th only. Tickets at denvercenter.org or call 303-893-4100.
I barely touched her.
Feud, Betty and Joan. March 5th, only on FX.
Drop that baby.
The classic show, An American in Paris, has made its way to Denver. Avery Anderson caught up with some of the cast and got a chance to see the show.
In 1951, An American in Paris hit the big screen and became an instant hit. More than 60 years later, the classic show is back for a new Broadway production.
I think the story, we think of this as a classical movie, but we've reinvented it. And it's no longer just like an old movie that we think about. It's a brand new, vibrant, big show that I think everyone can appreciate.
An American in Paris follows a soldier after World War II as he decides to not come home and live in Paris.
So the beginning of the show starts very sort of dark and gray and oppressive. And as the show goes on, especially in the second act, it gets brighter and more vibrant. And that is because of the growth of the story and the growth of the country and the growth of the characters.
The true highlight of the show, though, is the dancing.
Christopher took it a step further and said, well, we can really further the plot and really further the story by using our bodies as that medium.
In addition to some breathtaking dance, the lighting design was near perfection.
But our lighting designers have come up with an incredible projections for each scene. So the projections and the way that they're done and the way that they're designed visually is stunning. It's really worth a look.
An American in Paris is now playing at the Buell Theater through March 19th.
Thank you, Avery, for that. It seems like an amazing show to go watch this weekend. And I hear you have some other activities for us this weekend, Cree.
Definitely. We have some incredible artists and performers right here on campus. I caught up with Mailman to talk about some of his work.
Here at MSU Denver, students pursue both their educational goals and personal dreams. Students like to mail, a hip-hop artist on campus.
So my name is Mailman. It's just kind of a spinoff of my actual name, which is Tamil. My dad gave me that name, so shouts out to my dad.
Tamil, also known as Mailman, developed a passion for rapping at a young age. He's already released a music video for the song Temptation with Jiren Jackson.
I started when I was younger, just listening to music, you know, just kind of enjoying it. and just basically reciting raps that I've heard.
He keeps his education intertwined with music through his major and minor.
My major is broadcasting, communication with a focus on broadcasting, minor in music. Well, I chose to do the broadcasting because it goes hand in hand with music, you know, trying to get your foot in the door with the radio and just know people in that industry and actually being a part of that industry and being able to contribute to that while being able to contribute to like rapping and doing and lyrics and music. So that's kind of what I want to do with my major and with my education. So
I asked Mailman about his future plans as an artist.
This is something I definitely want to do with my life. I've been doing it for a long time, as long as I can remember. Yeah, I want to take it to the next level. I'm actually taking little steps to get there. I've done like Apollo, you know, I've kind of got a nice little following. I guess y'all check me out, you know, like on SoundCloud, Apple Music, under Mailman, M-A-L-E-M-A-N. And you can just see all my stuff and yeah, trying to gain my fame, so.
Well, you heard him. Check it out. For the Met Report, Cree Chavez.
Here are some Denver do's that you can enjoy on this unseasonably warm day. Are you deathly afraid of spiders? I have the perfect event for you. And by perfect, I mean terrifying. The Butterfly Pavilion is celebrating World Spider Day tomorrow. Experts will discuss the importance of spiders. There'll be crafts, games, and even live animal encounters. The National Western Stock Show Complex will be hosting the Rocky Mountain Horse Expo March 10th to the 12th. The expo features 150 events showcasing the beauty and athleticism of the horse. The main event features a music and light spectacle. Travel back to 1930s New York with the Nance at the Edge Theater. This play tells the story of Chauncey Miles and his performers with vaudeville and burlesque acts. The Nance will be shown at the Edge Theater until April 2nd. The sequel to King Kong, Kong Skull Island, premieres today. A mysterious island is home to many monsters, including the infamous King Kong. The movie stars Tom Hiddleston and Samuel L. Jackson. Those Denver dudes look exciting, but nothing is more exciting than the miracle of life. Check out this viral vid. A woman named Erin Dietrich can be seen here walking, exercising, and dancing while wearing a giraffe mask. This mama got 30 million views as she strutted, squatted, and waddled across our computer screens and into our hearts. Thanks for watching EMET. Have a festive World Spider Day. Sports is next.
At Metropolitan State University of Denver, our mission is to provide high-quality, accessible education that prepares our students for successful careers, postgraduate education, and lifelong learning in a global and technological society. Our values of diversity, access, and community help us provide opportunities for our students from all over the globe. In fact, we've just been named a diversity champion by Insight into Diversity magazine for 2016. Because at MSU Denver, we believe in transforming lives.
Look at me, I know what I am.
What's that?
So is he crazy?
He believes he's mentally ill. But he may be the most powerful mutant we've ever encountered.
They're coming and they're gonna kill you.
I have to know, is this real?
MSU Denver has made it to the RMAC tournament for the past 8 years, and this year was no different. The Roadrunners took on the Ore Diggers in the semifinals after an 80-73 win over Regis in the quarterfinals. Sunday, Detch beginning the show with a three from downtown. Showing the dominant side of him, Detch scores the first 8 points for the Roadrunners as the threes keep on raining. Mine staying right up there with the Roadrunners as Schopfer and Moeller have threes of their own. Cameron Williams with the three scores 11 points on the night. Schopfer with another three ends his night with 16 points. Detch, unstoppable. He goes for his fourth three. Williams team members showing a little love as he slams this one past Kada. One more layup from Schopfer and the Mines knock off the Roadrunners 70-61.
This is what college basketball is about. That game right there, where you have two teams competing their butts off for a championship to stay alive.
The Roadrunners began RMAC play this past weekend against their longtime rivalry, UCCS Cougars, and only one team decided to show up. The Roadrunners came into the final game at 3-0, looking for the sweep. Melissa Martinick puts UCCS on the board first in the third inning with a boomer to right field, putting Martinick on second and bringing in Whitney Weber for the 1-0 Cougars lead. UCCS with 5 shutout innings, and Brooke Lovas catching fire as this beauty soars past Amanda Nobles. Lovas, looking like an actual Roadrunner out there, slides into third with a triple and Bakovich home, putting the Roadrunners on the board. Lovas showing her speed again. She decides to run home off a flyout, and the game is tied at 2. A low throw from Matinick will bounce past Mulligan for a home Anderson for the 3-2 Roadrunners lead. And Nick Anderson going 3-for-3 and continuing an 8-game hitting streak. MSU Denver takes game 4 to complete the sweep.
It's a awesome feeling, honestly. We have been so like kind of up and down within preseason, so coming out here going 8-0 is awesome for us.
Apart from the softball and basketball teams here on campus, there's one MSU Denver team that you might not know much about. Here's Celeste Zubia with more.
There's a team here at MSU Denver that you might be a little unfamiliar with. It's the hockey team. This is a club team, and because of that, they only receive limited funding through the school.
There's a lot that goes into that. Ice time is very expensive. We only get 2 practices a week. We would love to have a lot more, but due to lack of funds, it's pretty much ice time. And I wish we had more, but we don't. They pay for us to drive a van 10 hours to a tournament, or for flights to get up to Michigan. Whatever it takes, they pay for it. And with lack of funding, it's hard sometimes. Sometimes you want a nice comfy bus to ride in, but we got 2 passenger vans stuffed with 20 guys in bags.
But despite that, they're still putting out their best effort on the ice.
I'd say even for a club, it's one of the hardest working teams I've been a part of. We have a great time together, but we're always working hard, always trying to get better. With the limited ice time that we do have, that makes it even more important that every second we're out there, we're working as hard as possible to be the best we can.
And if there's one thing they want you to know about them,
just how hard we work, how hard these guys work every day, day in and day out. They have jobs, they go to school, they come to practice, they play games. It's a lot. I think they should be respected and viewed as top-level athletes.
For the Met Report, Celeste Zubia.
All right, so baseball is home this weekend. They are playing New Mexico Highlands. However, our softball team is in Fort Lewis. And, you know, we wish them the best of luck this weekend, considering it's going to be a nice weekend. They have an hour of sunlight to play in these days.
I know. It's springtime. It's almost time for us to set our clocks forward 1 hour this Sunday at 2 a.m., so make sure you guys do that. And also make sure to change the fire alarm batteries that you have. And don't forget, you may want to get an extra hour of sleep in, so go to sleep a little bit earlier because we are losing that hour of sleep.
Yeah, definitely try to go to bed early on Sunday. And well, that's all the time we have for now. For all the latest campus news throughout the week, be sure to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And visit our website on mymetmedia.com.